Hello Inventors, this is Saurav. In this video, we will learn how we can create ball bouncing game using MIT App Inventor. So let me show you the demo first. So you can see that's our first screen of our bouncing ball game. Okay, now let's click on this start game button. And you can see ball is moving in the top side. Okay, and whenever it is falling like that, you have to catch this ball using this paddle. Okay, right. You can move this paddle left side or right side with your finger. Okay, like this. Now catch this ball again. Okay, and you have to that ball should be touched with that bricks. To win this game, you have to hide all these bricks. Okay, but make sure you have to catch this ball also. And you can see the ball speed is increasing whenever that touch the paddle. And you can see you win this game because now let's click on restart button. Now, how this game will over. So suppose the speed is increased, okay, ball speed is increased, and you're not able to catch this ball, okay, so then you will lose this game. You can see I'm not able to catch this ball, and you can see you lost this game, right? So that's the overall game we will create using MIT App Inventor. You can use this restart button to restart this game.
So here we go. So we are using your MIT App Inventor to create this app. Okay, now click on start new project, and my project name is ball bouncing. That's my first screen. Okay, now we need to design your start game screen. Okay, so I'm going to make it simple. Okay, so I'm going to use your one simple layout, and that one is vertical arrangement, and make this height and width is fill parent. Okay, and change this design to something orange, and click on user interface and drag and drop one button here, and change this button name to start game. Okay, and then I'm to change this background color to pink and make it font bold, and font size I'm to make it 18. Okay, now click on this vertical arrangement and make align to center and make align horizontal to center. Okay, you can design according to your requirement. That's the design. Okay, we already have created a lot of start game design. Okay, so I'm to make it simpler. Okay, now let's whenever someone click on this start game button, so we have to start a game. So for that we have to disable, it means visible off should be, this should be vertical arrangement visible off. And we need here one more layout, and that one is vertical arrangement again, and make this one is also fill parent, and make it height is fill parent. Now we need to drag and drop here one canvas. So click on drawing and animation and drag and drop your canvas like this, and make it width is fill parent and height is fill parent like this. Okay, now I'm going to change this canvas color, background color to black like this. And drag and drop your one image sprite. Okay, that one is your paddle, and I'm going to drag and drop one ball like this. Okay, now we have to create use your image. Make sure this ball color should be something, because we have this ball color is now black and our background color is also black. So I'm going to make this one is another color. Let's try green something. Okay, and make this radius at least 10. Okay, and you can change another color like orange. Orange is fine. Okay, now we have to create paddle. So for that I'm going to select one image, click on this image sprit one, and upload one picture, upload file, choose file. I have something, let me just check in a desktop. Yes, I have that one image. Okay, image one. I will give you the link of all these images in the description, or you can download this simple line image. Okay, so I'm to make this height is, let's automatic, but the width should be in a pixel, and I'm to make it 100 pixel. Let's see how it's work, but we have to decrease height also, so I'm to make this 200 pixel. Okay, no, this should not a 200 pixel, this should be a 50 pixel or more less. Yeah, it's fine. But this should be like 50 pixel with this, or 70 pixel look more fine. Not, this is not about look only, actually this is about we are, because we are playing your game, so that's why this should be something like that, smaller. Yes, great. Okay, you can change your paddle image also, Okay, now let's create some bricks. Okay, so I have one brick image. So it's a drag and drop one image split here, that one image split two, and click on this picture, upload file, choose file, and I have this one brick png. Okay, I'm going to upload this, and okay, that one, okay, it's too big, so I'm to make this width is 100 pixel. Okay, and the height I'm to make it 50 pixel. Let's see how it's work. Oh, it's too big actually, it's still, so I'm to make it 70 and make this width height is 30. Let's see how it's look now. Okay, it's now small. Okay, now we just need to command C or control C and control V. Okay, like at least there should be at least 6. Okay, 2, then 3, like this, so that all are our bricks. So we have to break this wall, you can say. Okay, or you can change the design also. Okay, you can make your lot more bricks. Okay, now let's do some code. Okay, now go to the block section. First we need to create one variable in a slice the bricks. So like you can say bricks. Okay, and create a list for that. So click on list and you can see here, make a list, and we know that we have 3, 5, and 6 items. So click on this setting icon and add on more, 4 more 2 5 and 6. Fine. Now click on this image split 2. Okay, and we have to find this one just here and just copy paste. Okay, like this, image split again, and one more. Now we have to change the name. Okay, so 2, then 3, then 4, then 5, then 6, then 7. Okay, cool, fine. So 5, 6, 7, fine. Now that's the list of our image split or bricks. Okay, now so whenever someone open this game, okay, whenever someone click on the start play button, so they will see that one. But we have to move our ball. Okay, and whenever ball is moving, so we have to move our ball in the left that direction or that direction. Okay, so for that click on block, and whenever the screen will in a slice, okay, or whenever you can say the whenever someone click on the start game button, okay, then we have to start a game. So click on this button. So whenever someone click on this button, then we have to set our ball speed. So click on ball and you will find set ball speed, this one, ball one speed, that one, and that should be in an ECL stage. We will make this speed is 10. 10 is enough for us. Okay, now this should be actually dynamic because we have to increase our ball speed also. So for that we will create one variable. So initialize one global variable, and that one is called speed. Okay, and that value I'm to make it 10. Okay, in initial, and this should be get speed, like this. Okay, now we are moving our ball. Okay, now what we will do, we have to change that direction also. Okay, so first thing what we will do, we have to drag our that paddle. Okay, because we have to drag that paddle because we are not able, whenever we are not able to catch this ball, okay, so that game will over. Okay, so we have to move this. Okay, so for that we will use here one thing, that one is dragged. Okay, so click on this image split one because we have to drag image split one, and you will find dragged this one. That one is simple code. Okay, now we just need to call here, click on image split one, and you will find your image split dot move. So where this one, and we have to just get current x and current y. Current x, we have to move it in a current x and current y. You can move it in the left or right. Okay, now this is fine. Now whenever ball is collide with this image split one, it means our paddle, the ball collide with paddle, then we have to move it again in the top. okay, to break this all these bricks. Okay, so for that, go to the block. Okay, now click on this image sprite 1 and you will find out whenever image sprite collide with. Okay, so now we have to check whenever image sprite collide, it means pattern will collide with anything. It means there is only one object, is ball. Okay, that will collide. So for whenever that will collide, then we have to change this ball heading. Okay, and you will find heading is this one. Okay, sad heading. So what is heading? So we actually, the heading will redirect that ball in the direction. Okay, so we have to choose your value. So heading value should be random. Okay, click on max and you will find this. Now the random value should be from 45. Okay, this should be from 45 to 135. And why I'm using a 45 to 35, because whenever we create a circle, okay, so 45, you know, this one in this way, like this way, okay, and in the 135 is like this way. It means we have to move this ball between 45 to 35. We are not going to move our ball in the downside or in the left or in the right only, because we have to move in the 45 degree or we have to move in the 135. Okay, so now go to the block. That's why we are using 45 to 35. Now we have to increase the ball speed also. So whenever image split collide with ball, then we will increase the speed. So for that, just set global speed. Okay, and then click on mass and you'll find a plus this one, and we have to fetch the current speed. It means get current speed and increase by 10. Right, and to increase by this is 10, or you can increase by 5 or whatever you want. Okay, now this is fine, but we have to set here speed also. It means we have to call this one is again here. Okay, now we have to call one thing here that is important, that is one is we have to bounce our ball. Okay, so how we can bounce our ball? So just call here one ball and you will find a ball dot bounce, this one. Okay, but this should be, we have to call, just right click on it and you will find make a Zendrick. Okay, and for a component, what we will use here, we will use your other, get other like this, and the age should be -1. Okay, and that one is -1. Okay, now that one is your code. Fine, now we have to use here one more thing, that how we can make it game over and how we can remove and how we can hide all these components. Whenever this ball touch this component, it makes image split, then we have to visible off that walls. So tomorrow we will learn all that things. Okay, so because this video is going long, so tomorrow we will complete this game. So if you have some doubt, you can ask me on comment, and if you want more features in this game, so just comment on the video. So thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe my channel, like this video and share this video. Have a nice day. Be safe. Bye bye.